Tupac isn't dead, he's on the moon, living there with moon men, having the time of his life. And then other guys are like, you're fucking stupid, he's living on Mars with Martians, having the time of his life. What is up, my beautiful TG beings? Yeah, that's right, I call you TG beings, because this gaming barrack community that we have here of directors and everything, we're like a small continent, the gaming barrack continent, and we don't live by no rules apart from killing bitches in video games, and we're all called TG beings, because what else would we be called? If we were called Ninja Men, that'd be unoriginal, so I just said, let's call ourselves TG beings, because it kind of sticks with the whole TGB thing. Anywho guys, this is Butch here, back again. I don't know why you guys let me in here again, because I'm just going to destroy this channel. I'm not going to destroy this channel. I'm going to love this channel like a child. I love children. God, I really do love the children. Anywho, this is some Modern Warfare 2, as you can see, sniping on Afghan. It's a bare bones free-for-all, because when I play Modern Warfare 2, I don't want to be screaming at Harriers like, get out of the sky and stop fucking shooting me, you bitch! Because, you know, it's just going to keep shooting me, and I don't want to get mad, so I'm just going to play some bare bones, because it's more, I don't know what you call it, it's not as hectic and as crazy, and of course, it, you know, anybody can get a good gameplay where they go like 50-2, and, you know, they could owe maybe 25 of their kills to like a chopper or whatever. But bare bones probably just shows more of that gun action that I think entertains people more. I don't know if I'm wrong about that, but I hope I'm right, because I like being right. But if I'm wrong, go ahead and say I'm wrong. Anywho, I'm not here to talk about the gameplay. Oh no, 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 no. You could be more wrong. I'm here to talk about something else. Something that I believe kind of helps me, you know, get to know you guys better, and for you guys to get to know me better, and you know, that helps each other grow into a blossoming relationship of director and viewer. And what I want to talk about is, you know, my story on YouTube, and of course I want to get a response out of you guys, as to why you're on YouTube and why you make videos. So I'm gonna go ahead and start by saying that I'm on YouTube since 2008. That's a very long time. I originally started making videos that were, you know, like fake phone calls. They weren't gaming related at all. It was just me and a friend pretending to be Biggie Smalls and Tupac, and pretending that we are still alive, and that we are good friends, that we never died. And that video got like 5,000 views, and my channel at that time had 0 subscribers, so I was like, what? This is kind of good. But I never gained any subscribers off that video, not a single one. But there was huge controversy in the comment section. And now, it wasn't because me and my friend made a bad video. It's because people were sharing their different theories on how Tupac dies. Like, one was saying, like, Tupac isn't dead. He's on the moon, living there with moon men, having the time of his life. And then other guys were like, you're fucking stupid. He's living on Mars with Martians, having the time of his life. And, you know, it was conflicting. And overall, the video just got fucking removed. It got flagged and it was removed. I don't know why, but anywho. And then when I got on Xbox Live, I jumped straight into a clan with some guys I met online, a Halo clan. And I just made some Halo videos, some very short Halo videos. And I had no fucking idea how to get my Halo gameplay onto the internet. I don't think, like, am I the only one here that when they saw gameplay on the internet, they were like, how the fuck do they get their Xbox onto the internet? I never heard of a capture card before. But yeah, my first video, gaming video, was back in 2009. It was a Halo sharpshooter. And back then, Halo kind of actually dominated the YouTube scene, you know. Commentaries wasn't really that big yet. You know, Hutch was probably one of the founding fathers of commentating. And he was still only, you know, up and coming at that time. So there was a lot of Halo on the internet. And, you know, I made a couple Halo videos. And after that, the clan I was in, we all disbanded. We just decided, like, you know, this is going nowhere, let's stop. And we're like, okay, let's stop. So I stopped making videos with the capture card from there on out, because I just wanted to showcase some hilarious things that me and the clan did, and we never kind of really got around to it because we just broke up. So my friend then, The first commentary I ever saw was actually by my friend. I still had never heard of Hutchinson or any of these guys, and this was when Black Ops was released. I know, that's only like 2 years ago, that's crazy. But my friend made a commentary with his Dazzle, and I was like, Jesus, this is fucking hilarious, and I have a gamer, a capture card, why don't I try this? So I started doing it, and of course, you know, when you start out, you have zero subscribers, and I don't even know where I got my first maybe 5, 10 subscribers from, but my first few videos kind of fell on deaf ears, fell on blind eyes because nobody was watching them. And then I heard of a community channel on, I was going through some COD forums and I heard of this community channel called Irish Gaming Central, and I'd never heard of it before. And they had like Machinima Partnership, and I was like, what? How have I never heard of this before? So I sent in the Halo video, a commentary, and it got rejected. And I don't know why it did, but a couple of weeks later, I made a new video talking about how my first video was rejected, and that was kind of met very well by the community. You know, I got over 500 views, lots of likes, and you know, that was like me kind of getting into the YouTube, kind of breaking it, sort of, because you know, I went from like 5 subscribers up to maybe like 60 or whatever, and then I stuck with IGC, Irish Gaming Central, like sending in a video every now and again. And eventually my subscriber count just started to grow. But like, that's a community channel. I wanted something where I could be like a director, where I could get, you know, guaranteed content up maybe on every 2 weeks or whatever. So I saw TGB and I was like, you know, this is something I'm gonna go for. So I went for it, and you know, here I am, I got it. I was ecstatic when I got it, and I just want to continue bringing you guys the best content that I possibly can, and you know, doing some variety, because you know, a lot of people are doing Modern Warfare 3. Not that there is a problem with that, it's just I like to do variety, and you know, what's more variety than doing a sniping free-for-all bare bones Modern Warfare 2, you know? But that's my story, I guess, up until now. You guys watching this, you know, I want you to comment below telling your story, or leave a video response about your story to this commentary. Either way, I want to hear from you guys on what your story is. That's mine. I don't think I left anything out, and you know, it's not really a real Cinderella success story, but that's me for now. I'm quite happy where I am in YouTube terms right now, and I'm quite happy to be here at the TGB. Oh yeah, the TGB one. I'm sorry, I just got dry mouth right there, and it just words messed up. Anyway, I went 30 and 7. Peace out.